Sunlight hurts my eyes. Something without wanna love bears heavy on my mind. Then I look at you, and the world's alright with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day. Instead of me, always seems to know the way. Then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day.
Hey guys, what's up? Getting ready to pull this motor on this 2003 Tahoe. So I got the tripod set up right here. I got my bucket set up for all the parts, keep everything organized. And we're gonna do a quick time lapse of pulling this motor out. So check it out, stay tuned. So that's just under an hour in, guys. I got the motor pretty much all disconnected, coolant system disconnected, power steering system disconnected, fuel system disconnected, AC disconnected. I did the exhaust before I started the film. So all that's left is to make sure everything's routed out of the way. There's nothing I forgot, any ground straps or hoses or lines that I forgot. You know, there's always one. Get underneath, knock out the bell housing bolts real quick, hook this motor and pull it. I got the exhaust dropped. I got all the bell housing bolts from under here that I could reach. There's two more at the top I'm gonna get from above. I got the torque converter bolts out. Starter dropped. All the other little clips and lines looks like it's off the motor. Crank sensor's unplugged. I got a bucket for the trans dipstick in case some trans spills, I could catch it when I'm going to maneuver the trans to get this motor out. So we'll get the rest of those bolts from up top. The exhaust I cut up because we're replacing it. We're replacing the cat converter. Had a universal on there and the cats were bad. Here's all the parts in my buckets, all organized. I got my bolts all organized in the sections they go in. I got a tray here. I got a tray over there on the rack arm. Two trays up top. So I know where all the bolts go when I go to put it back together. The bolts are where they go. But that's it, guys. Got it out. Nothing got broken that I see. Pretty smooth. Get this thing transferred over, everything transferred over that needs to be transferred over on the used motor and get it back in. Always inspect the used motor that you're about to put in for damage, you know, things that the guys at the junkyard might have cut that shouldn't have been cut, so you know to switch it over before you put the motor in. You got a bad motor mount, the other one was, they cut the bolt off so bad they cut into the motor mount, so I got to switch that over. And then I also noticed a couple other things on it. I got a blown out valve cover gasket. I was gonna do valve cover gaskets anyways, but I gotta pull these covers off, change out the gaskets. I'm gonna use the original intake, so I gotta order some intake gaskets. We get some spark plugs and wires ordered. I'm gonna stick with this water pump. These water pumps are easy enough to change out when they're in the truck, so that one looks fine. You always look for dents or damage on it. The rest we could clean up, so we'll stick with that. Sides look good. Now's the time to look at the oil pan, make sure the gasket's good. If you're gonna do an oil pan gasket, now would be the best time to do it. This is a little bent, I'll take that off, use the other one. Make sure everything's the same. Onto the other one didn't have the oil coolers. Yeah, that looks the same. So switch over that plastic, we gotta switch over these coils. Switch over the AC compressor and the belt. The tensioner on the used motor from the junkyard was making noise. Always check for bearings. Make sure bearings, everything spins good. So I'm gonna go ahead and pause it real quick and order these parts. I just wanted to mention a couple of things too about these used motors from the junkyard. Always inspect them. Like I said, check the wiring, make sure they didn't cut anything that you need. Or you know, make sure there's no cracks in the flywheel, anything that you're gonna put in the used motor, always check. I actually just found this bolt wedged behind the flywheel. So I probably wouldn't have noticed that, you know, if I wouldn't have expected it, I wouldn't have noticed that. I'd go to bolt this thing up and start it, and this thing would have wreaked havoc on inside there. So always double check, make sure everything moves, make sure everything's clean. You know, I'll clean these studs up because I'm going to use these manifolds. Check for broken bolts, like right there. We got a broken bolt. Got to get that taken care of. You know, things like that. You don't want to go and put this thing in and end up having to take it back apart because of reason. See, another broken bolt. Pretty common problem on these Vortex. So, just a quick tip there, guys. Guys, so I'm back home, long day at the shop, got the motor in, pretty much all that's left is fill up all the fluids, test run it, and deliver it to the customer. I was able to save the customer some money. Let me know what you guys think of the video. Quick day in the life, took me a couple days to make. You know, I do these videos for you guys, like I said. As always, leave me a comment, like, subscribe, don't forget about that tool giveaway, and we will catch you in the next one. Signing out.